the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us now call to mind our sins and ask God for pardon and strength. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who assigned St. Matthias a place in the College of Apostles, grant us through his intercession that rejoicing at how your love has been allotted to us, we may merit to be numbered among the elect. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter stood up in the midst of the brothers and sisters. There was a group of about 120 persons in the one place. He said, "My brothers and sisters, the scriptures had to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit spoke beforehand through the mouth of David concerning Judas, who was the guide for those who arrested Jesus. Judas was numbered among us and was allotted a share in the ministry. For it is written in the book of Psalms, 'Let his encampment become desolate, and may no one dwell in it, and may another take his office.' Therefore, it is necessary that one of the men who accompanied us the whole time, the Lord Jesus, came and went among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day on which he was taken up from us, become with us a witness to his resurrection." So they proposed to Joseph, called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed, "You, Lord, who know the hearts of all, show which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in this apostolic ministry from which Judas turned away to go to his own place." Then they give lots to them, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was counted with the 11 apostles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
Praise you, servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
From the rising to the setting of the sun is the name of the Lord to be praised. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is his glory.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
Who is like the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high and looks upon the heavens and the earth below?
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
He raises up the lowly from the dust. From the dunghill he lifts up the poor to seat them with the princes of his own people.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
Please stand. I chose you from the world to go and bear fruit that will last, says the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you, and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I love you. No one is greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Before I share with you my thoughts, I'd just like to take this opportunity to belatedly, no? Belated lang kasi wasn't able to attend, to greet our dear sister Marianne on her silver anniversary last May 1, no? And of course to our dear mother May on her birthday, no? So belated greetings to our dear sisters and mother. Our feast today is about St. Matthias, also a kind of a belated apostle. Nga, because he was just a replacement for Judas Iscariot. If you want to see that way, parang, ay, doon na ulihi lang siya? Doon yung sugpon lang? You've heard from the first reading how the apostles were reduced to 11 because of the betrayal of Judas. And so they said that it should be 12. And so they added Matthias. And maybe that's the reason why St. Matthias is least well-known compared to the other apostles. Kasi ulihi lang siya gindugang. Pero ulihi gid bala gindugang si Matthias? Was Matthias just merely a replacement? Well, the answer is no. Sa kamatuoran, tradition holds that Matthias had been with the Lord ever since the Lord started the ministry. In one tradition, in one of the traditions, it is said that Matthias is one of those who were sent by the Lord, na tagduwa-duwa, remember in the gospel, during the middle of the ministry of the Lord. He called his disciples and sent them two by two to all the towns of Judea and Galilee. According to tradition, one of those 72 is actually Matthias. And others, there are others, like the disciples to Emmaus. They are considered part of the 72. So in some sense, by that tradition in the church, in terms of the lives of the saints, Matthias is not someone nga gindugang lang. He is destined to be part of the 12. It just so happened that he has to wait for the proper time, in God's time, before he is added to that privileged position of one of the 12 apostles. Pero ever since, Matthias is already a disciple of the Lord. He might be somewhat silent, not well known, but he is faithful to the Lord. And that's precisely the reason why, by the drawing of lots, no? The lot fell on him. And he was chosen to replace Judas. Now, my dear friends, in our lives, I think that's how it is, no? Faithfulness even in obscurity. Faithfulness even if you are not unknown. Sometimes you have to lay low. Most often, we only take notice when people are on top, well-known and famous. And maybe that's the reason also why even among us, for example, well, if I'm going to connect that to my personal life, no? Even among us priests, we have to do something in order to be noticed, no? Kasi yung mga pari yan nga, mapisan magpatindog sa simbahan, no? mag-abot sa, especially kung mag-reshuffling, no? Mugina. For those of you who are familiar with the life of the parish, kung mag-reshuffling gani na, siguraduhon mo gid, may gubaon ginadara, may baguhon ginadara, may patindugon ginadara. Nga ah. Kaya mga tao, para sa ilang estimation, sa ilang pagtansyar, kung ang pari wala sa may ginapaubra, wala sa may ginapatindog, wala sa may ginapakaayo, hindi nami. Though politiko, mambala, kaya na may project. Well, because the people wants it, no? But then again, that is not the only way by which we come to be to follow the Lord, no? Tiyan mo na siya. In our own personal lives, no? as laity and religious and clergy, sometimes we need to take notice that God works in mysterious ways and in His own time. Sometimes we only have to wait. But not so much because you wanted that position. If it is meant for you, then it's for you. But whatever, what is important is we remain faithful. We remain faithful to God even in obscurity. So Matthias is one of those examples by which we can take, we can emulate or imitate. He was silent. The only thing we know about Matthias is that he is on his election. Tapos hindi wala na. We have never heard him in the gospel. We have never heard him being named in the gospel. And in the Acts of the Apostles, after this, you'll never hear it again about him. Wala lang. Baraan mo lang ito. And again, it points to the mysterious ways of God. Ikaw pa makutunta ganit, yan ang role ni Judas yan. Para lagi ba lang mag-betray kay Jesus? Tinong role ni Matthias? Para lagi mag-replace sa kay Judas? Many questions that would remain unanswered. And that points again to the mystery of God's work in His church and in our lives. God works in His mysterious ways and reasons might not be able to be explained or explicated. Pero ang importante, we look at Matthias as a faithful disciple of Jesus. Whether he is known or unknown, he remained faithful to the Lord. Sabagay, in contrast, no? His faithfulness is contrasted to his predecessor, Judas. No? Kung ano ka-traidor kay Judas, amo man ka-faithful si Matthias. In obscurity or in fame, Matthias remained faithful to Jesus. Please all stand. Let us now pray for the grace to remain faithful to the Lord, even in moments of doubt and difficulties. And so we pray, Lord, keep us in your love.
Lord, keep us in your love.
May the shepherds of the church entrust themselves to God and to the power of His word that is able to build them up and give them the inheritance among all who are sanctified. We pray.
Lord, keep us in your love.
May the church be assured of younger leaders who will take up the responsibilities of those who are in retirement or are incapacitated, we pray.
Lord, keep us in your love.
May government and civil leaders remain faithful to their responsibilities and not be blinded by the lure of money like Judas Iscariot, we pray.
Lord, keep us in your love.
May we remain in Jesus' love by keeping His commandments, even to laying down our lives for our friends. We pray.
Lord, keep us in your love.
May we respect the dignity of each person whom Jesus calls his friend, appointed to bear fruit for the glory of God. We pray.
Lord, keep us in your love.
Lord, it was you who chose Matthias to be numbered among the 12 to the prayer of the believers. May the church continue her mission to witness to the love of Jesus who makes the believers his friends. Amen.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, the offerings of your church reverently presented for the feast of Saint Matthias, and through them strengthen us by the power of your grace through Jesus Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty in our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with all the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, let it do for us, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, we shall be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricio, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Sebastian, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calungsod, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. And by your help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Never cease, O Lord, we pray, to fill your family with divine gifts. And through the Blessed Matthias' intercession for us, graciously admit us to a share in the lot of the saints in light, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is offered.